danat.
Oh, jadi gini. This camera. See, this is life. You make sure it doesn't go off now. If it goes off, you press here. Soft touch. I think when it wants to go off, so now you'll be cheating. Give it to the MCs to announce.
Okay, MC.
Give it to the MCs to announce. Is it 9:45? Yes, now.
MC, this
mass intention. Give the person his answer. Please give me space. I'm showing somebody something. So now. I see. You see, we are moving it. I'm not moving it with force. Cross your leg this way. I'm not moving it with force. I'm not moving it with force. Are you seeing it? This camera is not moving from here. It's covering views. they were moving it very gently. So once I want to get this in the map, you know, I pan it a little bit down. It's looking this on focus. I see it. Not even that, watch. You're just working and focusing this view. Okay, this is, you want to get private for now. You guys should be ready by now. Cross in here is not allowed. Come here. Come, Willie, come. Two of you are in charge of this camera, okay? Sometimes you may get tired. You change that. You remember what they told you about tilting and pounding? You don't do it before. So I want to turn it back to the order. See where I'm going. See where I'm going. So this is the interview that is going live. So you see. Bishop will come. Call them, tell them I said they should go. Comme hier. What do you mean by if you have the mass version? Is that what is it leading to produce or what? Push, respect yourself. Just respect yourself. So I get in there now. What? The thing is life now.
You don't tell anyone come.
Wisdom.
Yes.
What's your camera?
Yeah?
What's your camera on board?
Okay, oh, Ferdinand Ubu.
during.
Thank you.
happy for me. You told me what to be doing here, right? Offer a JP for me. You see, I told you guys to be here.
Thank you. Yeah. Scriptural songs, with thankfulness in your hearts to God. the Lord Jesus.
Giving thanks to our Father, to you. The word of the Lord.
This shall be from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 17, verses 11 to 19. Jesus has died in the manner of thanking God for everything he received, which the secretary will receive more from God. But most times, we neglect to thank God. But as the man has seen, I didn't believe him, and I got here, from the Gospel of Luke. He will listen and ask him. Was no one found to return and give grace to God except this foreigner?
Almighty God bless you with his life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The chief celebrant of this mass, most welcome, Harrison Webber. My senior is also here, very reverend Dr. Frederick Olivier, who just came back from a small organization where we work on the rest to make it possible for us to walk here. Very reverend Father. My fellow priests, Reverend Christophers, knights and their ladies, my brothers and sisters, the students of the boss, Bishop Okoye, Secondary School. Praise be to Jesus.
I am happy to be here to participate in the celebration of the 10th anniversary of this school, founding of this school. At this time here, when Father Christopher was conceiving the idea of erecting the school, I didn't know this school would eventually become something like this, what we are seeing today. I want to be fast about the number of time. Human life is what living, perhaps, can be and ought to be measured in what we do. In every society, there exist great possibilities which can be analyzed for the improvement of human life. Our society, though blessed, is filled with many people who are poor, hungry, subject to disease, living in excruciating conditions, unemployed and unemployed. Suddenly, why a microscopic few are living in lovely areas? The vast majority of men and women live in plebeian peril. Yet, we can help in our own little way to make life very meaningful and enjoyable to others. This was what made Reverend Dr. Christopher Amobos to conceive the idea of building this prestigious secondary school to make it easier for the people of God to give their children quality education without risking the distances and possible road mishaps. Since we are talking about a school and circumstances that led to this event, it is wonderful to observe that starting a university in California was also a challenge of circumstance. Leonard Stanford was once governor of California in 1876. He bought the first of what would have become more than 8,000 acres of land on the San Francisco Peninsula. Leonard and James Stanford had one son, Leonard Jr. But he never attended Harvard University. He died at the age of 15 on a family trip to Italy from typhoid fever. Within a few hours of his son's death, Stanford said to his wife, "The children of California shall be our children." That was the beginning of Stanford University. The founder of Harvard University was also circumstantial. However, a soldier and the founder of Harvard University was also circumstantial. However, a soldier and deeply religious man, known as the Christian General, has joined others in helping to establish the first Congregational Church of Washington on November 20, 1867. 11 members of the church gathered at the home of the Emeritus Presbyter for additional meetings. While they had resolved to establish a seminary for the training of African American ministers, especially for the South and Africa. It started as a seminary and bloomed to a university. The Holy Ghost Fathers, through the instrumentality of Reverend Father Dr. Christopher Wilson, have joined the league of those who cannot sit and watch children of God being subjected to difficulties that can be handled. We have been doing it, it is in our character. This school has grown and is growing, and I pray if we have a university annexed to it, or satellite campuses of Spiritual University Lodge established here. It is the celebration of the toys, the sleepless nights, the worries and anxieties over whether the dream will become a reality, the uncertainties associated with the paucity of form, the fear that the goal may not be achieved, and all of that teething problems that a youth school goes through. Like St. Paul, there were thorns on his flesh, whose strength was choking to death. God assured him of his graces, and this same grace that will give to each and every one of us. Boss is a product of God's grace, which we celebrate today in gratitude to God. The theme of gratitude runs through the three readings of today. In the first reading, from the prophecy of Isaiah, the prophet recounts the merciful love and goodness of Yahweh to the house of Israel. Sometimes we take it for granted that sleeping and rising is very simple. When you sleep, your heart is beating, your kidney is functioning, your liver is intact. Everything you do is doing your work. Don't you know that's the year? Any day you wake up is a year, and you must thank God for that. We have lost the idea of being grateful to God each time we wake up in the morning. Every day we attend Mass, a miracle happens. An ordinary man, a priest of God, prays over ordinary wine
and bread, and it becomes the body and blood of Christ. A miracle.
And was grateful to that. Some of you came here to travel all the way from long distances to be here. I want you to recognize the fact that you must pray for God. Many people started the journey they took from us, and it's happening every day. In the second reading of today, taken from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians, Paul admonishes us to do everything that we need to God. The gospel of today places before us two categories of people, the grateful and the ungrateful ones. Here, Luke gives a short episode in which God cured 10 lepers. But only one, a foreigner, returns to express gratitude. The story of Mary, a testimony to the healing power of Jesus, but it's so concerned with the attitude of those who have met God's blessings. Jesus' compassion is freely offered to each one of us, but we must also acknowledge what God has done through him. To faith must be added thanksgiving. When I asked Job, what happens when you are grateful? God will provide a full answer. The benefits of practicing gratitude are endless. People who practice gratitude regularly by taking time to notice and reflect upon the things they are thankful for, experience more positive emotions. They feel more alive. They sleep better. They express more compassion and kindness, and even have stronger immune systems. And yes, the person who makes such acknowledgement experiences a salvation which goes beyond the merely physical cure. Healing is a represent for a meaningful life, but gratitude is a part of one's holistic salvation. The grateful celebration of the gospel today indicates the universality of faith and possible salvation. They neither went to letters, are like the Pharisees who failed to recognize the presence of Jesus in their midst. Away from the spiritual, this story can find many negative characters in our society today. Why are there so many ungrateful people in war? Why do we have soldier friends with angelic faces around us? Why are people so wicked to those who extend to them a hand of friendship and help? These are some of the questions that beg for answers today. But Jesus does not want us to be distracted by the attitude of the ungrateful mind lepers. Instead, he wants us to emulate the one who understood the power of thanksgiving. As a kid, my father taught me to be grateful even for the smallest of favors I received from him. When someone paid me a visit, my father insisted, for the first time, I must express my gratitude by giving him or her a gift. If I visit any family and the mother of that family cooks food for me, I must give her money in appreciation of her meal when she comes to collect the plates. I kept doing this. My father is late. I wanted to ask him whether I could repeat my visit to the same family, whether I would still give the woman or the mother of the house a gift, because I was wondering that I have money to be out. Alright. Today, it is amazing. All the children come to thank God. You know, some of us come to thank God with rumpled and dirty coins. Six animals, tiny tubers of yam, withered vegetables, and overriding plantains. You can have yours. And so we grateful to us. We are gathered here to celebrate the 10th anniversary of Bishop Okoye Spiritual Secondary School. May I say that after the resolution preparation, 10th December 2005, the Spiritans, Mata family, and many well-meaning Christians, we are standing before the rubicon which needed to be crossed. It was a time of grief and sober reflection. To cross the rubicon is a pretty difficult task of the day, yet it is not possible. It entails making a grateful decision and being ready and willing to bear the outcome. So after the plane crash, a wonderful but very tasty decision was made. The outcome of that decision is boss, whose 10th anniversary we are celebrating today. We are grateful to God and to those who spearheaded the task of building this standard of moral values and knowledge, especially in the institute of the Holy Ghost Fathers and Brothers in Nigeria, late very Reverend Professor Osman Nene. And the studio who was there in South East and giving his useful pieces of advice, the very Reverend Father, Christopher Otos, our outgoing South Eastern Provincial Superior, Father Abonobo Peter. We thank God also for Father Barrister Christopher Otos, the principal of course, the Provincial Superior, our present Superior, Gregory Deni, who continues to give his support to this school, and all those who continue to animate and sustain this pastor of excellence. We say thank you to all of you. There are some magnificent buildings today called schools, but most of them are main actors for the annual charters of overfed children. What a good school should do is to guide and direct the path of our children towards self-actualization. We are not just enthralled by magnificent buildings and serene ambience of course, but we are celebrating because of our vision, our mission, moral standard, and academic glories, which continue to restore even beyond the emblem of Nigeria, the reason that is even beyond the emblem of Nigeria. My first student of boss, to send you here is one of the best decisions your parents have made, of which you must be eternally grateful. Mary Magdalene was an embodiment of gratitude. All we know of her is that out of her Jesus cast out seven demons. Confirm Luke chapter 8, verse 2. She could never forget what Jesus had done for her.
It was Mary Magdalene's motto written on her heart. I will not forget what Jesus has done for me. For one act of goodness, she spent her whole life in gratitude. She understood love.
They can fully repay even the smallest act of kindness. Be forever grateful. It is a fact that you can't have the luxury you enjoy at home here. And don't even pray for it. You are now in a totally
different environment where you must try to create and rebuild yourself positively. People's desire for easy life and for comfort often make them perpetually dependent on others to do for them what they could do for themselves. And this can hinder them from exercising their initiative and creativity. This is never to be found among you. Don't celebrate business. Aspire and perspire for greatness. Don't say my family is well to do, therefore, I don't need to work hard in order to create a life. This is a global cause mentality. A belief by backward people that someday, without any exertion whatsoever on their part, a fellowship will talk with their partner, learning with every good they have always dreamed of possessing. This is a dwelling in Prema, a world of fleeting shadows. The world is changing. The world is changing and must change along with it. Be independent in the sense of standing on your feet to engage the world of productivity. It begins from here. Boss should give you a good foundation to build and build on. Embrace the process. To the parents and guardians of our students who continue to trust and believe in the spirit for the holistic education of their kids, your choice, of course, is the best. You have seen what we can do with the funds you have entrusted to us. Continue to support our projects. Churches projects will never disappoint you. To the staff and management of us, may your efforts record even greater successes. That our visitors and friends, welcome to us. I want to thank all of you for the contribution, for the support, for all you have done to make this school a reality. I pray that God will continue to bless and support each and every one of you. Long live Bishop Okoye Spiritual Secondary School. Long live the Holy Ghost Fathers and Brothers. Long live our provincial superior, Reverend Father Dr. Gregory Gayle. Long live Reverend Father Dr. Barrister Christopher Mopas. Long live Reverend Father Gregory Gayle. Peace be with you.
Divine presence. forward.
Instead of sitting down to
complain about our situation, it made a difference in the landscape of the academic life of this country. We too should take up the challenge to bring some impact and to make a difference in spite of whatever bedevils our progress in this country. Therefore, let us ask our Mother Mary to assist us in our prayers as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Thank you.
will be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
Sanctify the bread, O Lord, the offerings made here, and cleanse our hearts by the light of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. And once more, give thanks, He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We prepare the Lord and profess the resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray. Now partake of the body and blood of Christ. We may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Augustine, our Bishop, Christ, whom we celebrate here today, and all the clergy in town, whom your Son has given to us.
Remember your sons, Father Blessing and Yannick, Father Malachi and Israel, who you call from this world to yourself, that the day when you are born with them like this, we also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all of God in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. And mostly in us all we pray. For the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Saint Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have been to throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-wise and eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, I form and you say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, O Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church." And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will. You will live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you. Thank you. May we sit, please?
here today. But before I was not anything, I'm blocking you out to our students and taking their bad day today. So the bad day students, please come forward.
suffering. It's a special day for us, a special day for them too. And we pray that Almighty God will not bless you, bless your families, friends, and well-wishers, and grant you many more fruitful years today through Christ our Lord. May I put our hands to the seat. We are not clapping for them.
Yeah! Thank you. friends, please start coming.
Thank you.
Okay, one more people, please. One more group, please. The Papa Nines. Please, sorry for meeting that. Please, it was a very big mistake. We welcome the Papa Nines for the Thanksgiving. Please, may you come forward. The Papa Nines, if you're here present, please start coming for your Thanksgiving.
Thank you. Almighty, O Lord, we thank you. We thank you. It's only you that could do all these things. It's only you that could do all these things. The Holy Spirit and you, O Lord, are the only ones that could do this.
So we tend to love this album for the the Spirit is through me. Please permit the Father Superior to walk by the Spirit and direct me. Thank you very much, Father. Because if you say no, I will close. The Spirit is moving me. I don't know if I'm going to stop me. Mr. Reader, the Spirit is telling me to you.
Thank you.
Glory to Jesus. Dear parents, we are not short of this need for support at this moment. What in America that is talking to will believe in the conscience of time and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. That is a particular segment of today's faith anniversary. Most of you will enjoy. However, let me invite Mr. Charles Tabansi, please. Please come forward. Please put your hands together for him, please.
Parents, please clap. Students, clap for me. You guys see what is going on in the Eco Garden. Whatever you see there needs to work good the job. But it's going to be 7 million in that thing. You're going to see what is going on there. And he's doing more. After this, every parent will go there to see the art. Within the entire facade of that environment, every piece of what you have done so far and what you meant to be completed, enjoy fully under the project. He doesn't have a daughter here, he doesn't have a son here, but he believes in the Holy Ghost Fathers. When he came to that place, you're not coming. Someone trust us and we can go. Because we had another activity somewhere to attend. He said, just to say a word to the provincial about the Eco-Garden.
representing parents of our graduates, our pioneer graduates. Any of them here? Pioneer graduates,
any of the parents around? Okay, so please,
all our wards, please bear with us. We're going to take care of it in the field so that we can get into the next activity. We don't keep everybody here waiting for that.
Before our provincial comes to thank everybody, I have this obligation also to thank our pioneer teachers. The 11 of our pioneer teachers, the 11 of our pioneer teachers, Paradepi is going to invite all of you so that they have been with this school for almost 11 years. Put your hands together for them, please. Teachers have been coming and going for several species of reasons, but this one says, we stick with us, come rain, come shine. So please, we just want to appreciate them here, then we'll do the final 10 steps for them, then we'll shut down and move to the field, please. Thank you.
So that was the time. We welcome our pioneer teachers to please come forward to the altar. Mr. Hassan, Mr. Garba, Mr. Hani.
Thank you.
They did a lot. Two shadows from here, please. Minister, Mazi, please come forward. Please put us together for the institutional training. The people of peace. A group of 13 young men and women, they don't have this year. They have nothing to do physically the Bishop of Oyo. But they believe in us. They continue contributing. Initially, when the place started, the cars were used for a pastor. They did all the things. So please, you come forward. They also received an award today. Please put us together for them. We're going to do a presentation here. That's for the presentation. Secretary members, please take that chairman come and represent you. Chairman, silence is the group. Please pray together for the CTFC members. Within the BOT, all of us are going to go away. We are looking out for Mr. Tony Ebuche. Is Mr. Tony Ebuche here? Pastor of the Lord, please come forward. Please pray together for them. These are the people who believe in the Bishop of Oyo. They are not physically present, but they are going to take place subsequently out there. And within the threshold of our activities also, we invite Mrs. Aldora. Please come forward. Please put a stand for these people. Once in a while today, because of what they have done, because of who they are, we are talking about representation. Is the PTA chairman here, Mr. Sam Emmanuel? Please let's see what people are around. And please also help us to please put a stand for representation. And your team, please come forward. We thank you so much for all the parents. We're symbolically doing this so that Bishop will bless you. Some parents who donated to the building of the teachers' quarters. And the Bremont is Bremont here. Even I call him Ingram Roger. Ingram, please come forward. Please let's not because of want of time. Please put a stand for these people who believe in Bishop Okoye, who donated. They made that dream come true. They sincerely endorsed and supported everything we are doing. Mr. Cosmos Ago, you can see the facade. The road network was down because people also believe they must. As such, if you are waking, please come forward. These are the men who did everything for Saturday structures. Please give me one symbolically and let me represent all the groups because of all the time. We thank you so much, the feedback, for the great work you did for us. We can't thank you guys enough for believing in Bishop Okoye.
So that their vision for their own personal preoccupations
will flourish through Christ our Lord. Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you.
Please put your hands together once again for them. Chief Pastor Woba, finally please, dear parents, we all know that at every event people take the tashir of the commitment. I cannot tell Father today without saying something about sisters of help. The children who died in sisters of help, I know I've seen some of the parents already. I wouldn't want to go back in great respect to our little wound of pain, but it's also faith. Please, move our heads if you want to stand next to these children. May we rise, please? Please rise by your head. A moment of silence for the children. Put our hand together for the spouse of the baby. May the soul of the citizens of heaven and the souls of all faithful departed through the blessings of our Lord. May the souls of all the citizens of heaven and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God. May they rest in peace. May they rest in peace. May they rest in peace. Please be seated. Mr. Ferdinand, we thank you for your fire. We cannot thank you enough. Please put your hands together and see how beautiful the fire is. Please clap for them, please, parents. Thank you, Mr. Fernand, and thank you guys too for all the sacrifice. Despite the activities of the tradition, you could have a quality time to thank you. Also, we have two significant events after this. The blessing of our Lady of Fatima Koto. Sabelo, by Sabelo, came here. You know, in this church, God talks to people. He said he prayed, and Jesus said he do something for the school. As the story told me, and he somehow almost forgot. And months after the wife came and told him, Nali, you promised God something. He said, no. He said, remember, I promised. I went to church to pray, and God told me, you promised to do something for him. Think about it. And he remembered. He said, yes. I promise the Lord that I will be a motto for us. And today, parents, dear ones, what a promise from God. That's the motto I'm going to bless you, which will be almost 5 million to be open to school. Only when I saw our lady, his father, this one is coming from Italy. People know what it means, and important things from Europe. Exchange rate. He closed his eyes. Did everything to ensure that this came to fruition. My Lord, please, I will think myself a very important conscience after they do all this and God bless it for them on this day. Please, where did Pete go? Are you there? Where is he? Oh, good. Pete. And Lisa, where is he? You guys come out. Let our parents also let go of this. Our parents can do things for school and also to bless. Where's your reason? Where's your sister? Is she upstairs? Yeah, I know you're a fly. Please, come over here. The song that you take, already knew where Pastor Fellow. So we thank this family for doing this to us. And also know what our parents do in any little way, in any way. The big, middle, you have something to contribute. But they go to the church. Always a big place. Yeah. And you can see how the kids are looking. We'll come to that later on. Because my parents are having to go and see 50,000 times. People are saying so many things. It's unfortunate though. People don't know how we walk.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God our Father, when the said children came asking for help from you, your disciples reminded you of the fact that they have built synagogues for worship to your Father. and you did not hesitate to go and bless or to his bidding. Here, it's a family that are built to the glory of your name. May you also pray for them. Unite them in their family and lay your hands upon them so that you will use them to bring to you greater things. May their children benefit from the blessing that they are having from you today and always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you.
Look at them. They're not even happy.
You can see this gentleman. This is the new logo of academies. One time, one by one, one world. Father Bin also for Cambridge and SAT are in chapter 3 exams. Father Don, you can see sometimes I don't know whether he's one of the students when he wears his nicker and his shirt. This is making us great. We thank God in a very special way for that. Thank you, fathers. Finally, Father Provincial, we welcome everybody. We thank everybody. I hope I'm not forgetting anyone. The sisters who visited us, the Clarissa sisters, all the way from my home in Anambra. Please clap for the sisters. The sisters of Handmaid of a Child, please, from New York, let's get also for them. Sisters of Jesus, the Savior, they're also here. And sisters of St. Joseph, they've also come and they've gone, sharing this table with us. We thank you also for being Bishop Okoye, what we do these 10 years, and for our team in students. You guys have been wonderful. You can see what they are putting on. The pastor is not here. I really thank Father Bin in a very special way. Bringing the concept, you can see all after master, of course, we dress in this, looking special. Looking wonderful, looking great, looking magnificent, looking awesome. In any way, please put your hands together for Jesus. For this great work they have done for us. We thank everybody. So, for the alumni, Father Oji, please, a big one. For the alumni, on a day like this, we've seen a lot of our students who are already here. Boss has produced teaming students, and they are doing so well. All over the whole globe, in Africa, in Asia, body, whatever. My father knows a few words after that we invite the provincial, then the father blesses to the mission. was our gift here, and today, being Saturday, we are celebrating this 10 years. So that goes to God, that is each and every one of us. But I want to tell also the bishop.
on.
Let me not continue to repeat all the things that I can say, but I really thank all of you. I have a youth. You know that you are the drivers of this establishment. So we are so happy. And I want to begin to go and thank everyone. But let me now say something before I say, if you read this book, this person,
those adjectives by saying this is an award-winning school. I saw two postings on the way coming of people who have earned kind of an award for you. Please continue to do so, because your parents are spending so much on you. And parents, this shows that
all our guests, friends, and volunteers who have kind of been there out there in the field, our parents must treat them with the debts. Now, we are also trying to remind all of us, the alumni especially, that there will be a football match at the end of our event. So we'll move from here and have a photograph to give the Lord bless the Proto and the St. Francis Paul's Football Academy. Thank you all, and God bless you.